We started with the praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's all praise due to Him. And we ask of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send abundant salutations on our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are very fortunate today, alhamdulillah. Number one, for having a very special guest. And number two, the lecture that will be given today will be broadcasted live on the radio station. So we make dua, inshallah, that those that are present and everyone that is listening on the radio, that they take maximum benefit, inshallah. I mean, so who's our guest speaker? And they requested me to call it, keep it short and sweet, inshallah. It's none other than Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi. And he's more widely known as Sheikh al-Nanawi. So we welcome our honored guest, alhamdulillah. Radio, they just mentioned now that it's Radio 76 that will be broadcasting today, inshallah. Just a very short bio, inshallah. Sheikh al-Nanawi is the founding director of the well-known Medina Institute that we know of, currently in Cape Town. But these institutes are not only specific to South Africa, rather it is got these campuses in the United States, United Kingdom, Canada, Norway, Sudan, and Malaysia, mashallah. And these are the efforts that have been done all over the world to ensure that the legacy of Islam continues. Sheikh Nanawi is a graduate of the Al-Azhar University. He also has a doctorate, a PhD. He's a doctor in the sciences of Hadith. And not only has he restricted himself to Islamic knowledge, rather he has a bachelor's degree in microbiology as well as a doctor of medicine. So we make dua, inshallah, that we're able to take maximum benefit from the lecture and the knowledge he wishes to share with us today, inshallah. So we call on Sheikh Nanawi, falyatafaddal, mashkura.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين ورضي الله عن أزواجه وأصحابه وأحبابه وذرياته أجمعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. On the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, on the 10th year of Hijrah, the year is year 10, and Sayyiduna sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam departed year 11. The zaman, the time is year 10. Of Hijrah, a year before the departure. The day is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, and the place is Mecca al-Mukarramah. The speaker is no other than Sayyiduna sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam Muhammadun Rasulullah. The occasion is Hajj, and the Imam of the Hajj is the Imam of the Anbiya himself, and the Amir of the Hajj is the Amir of the Umam and the nations and the communities himself. And the specificity of this Hajj, it is that it is the final, the only one, and the final one. The one and the only Hajj that Sayyiduna sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi wa sallam did. He sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam summoned the Sahaba, obviously, there in Arafah or Mina. There were speeches in both. The ulama of the seerah estimate, census was not known yet, that the number of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum were maybe around 114,000 Sahabis, according to Abu Zura. Some go as far as 140. Are all standing doing the manasik of al-hajj. لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. With these voices of Tawheed, at the symbol of Tawheed in Mecca and the Kaaba, with the Nabi of Tawheed, who is the continuation of the message of the hero of Tawheed, Ibrahim al-Khalil, alayhi salatu wassalam, النبي المصطفى صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم delivered his sermon خطبة الوداع. Oftentimes people understand it as خطبة, simply a sermon, only to be reminded and maybe surprised as well to some by سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس حبر الأمة وبحرها, the ocean of the knowledge of this ummah, saying and swearing by Allah in an Allah's name, he saying والله إنها لوصيته, by Allah this is not just merely a khutbah, a sermon of Arafah, but by Allah, this is his final will for the whole ummah. And there's a difference between a khutbah, a sermon, and a final will. And Nabi al-Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, in this khutbah has said on a couple of occasions, meaning within the khutbah, لعلي لا ألقاكم بعد عامي هذا. I may, oh people, listen to me, for I may not see you after, or you may not see me after this year in this place. Oh people, listen to me, for I may not perform Hajj this next year or the after this Hajj this year. All this. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is informing the ummah of what is maybe to come, that this is his last time, and as he is the father of the ummah, all the ummah, because the mothers, the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi are the honorable mothers of the ummah. Wa azwajuhu ummahatuhum. His wives are their mothers, and they are the brothers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. So if the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi are the mothers of the ummah, and the members of the family are all brothers, then the father of the ummah is no other than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And as the father of the ummah, before he departs and leaves the ummah, he leaves a final will for the ummah. And therefore, looking at the sermon of Hajjatul Wada' or Khutbatul Wada' ought to be from the angle of not simply a khutbah or a sermon that was delivered, but from the point of a final prophetic will for all time to come, not just to the Sahaba present, but to the entire Ummah until the Day of Judgment. And that's why Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi wa sallam tells them, وطبعاً الروايات are plenty, and I have not seen a complete version yet, and I've been working on one maybe for 20 some years. What we have out there is generally a segment of it, not all of it. And maybe with research, inshallah, we'll come to something maybe resembling close to it. لكن what we all agree on is hadith al-sahih, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم tells them, أيها الناس, O people, which month are we in? الصحابة رضي الله عنهم know which hajj or which month hajj falls in. لكن when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, after he told them that I may not be with you the next year, or I may not be with you after this year, as if this overtaken some of the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, maybe especially the ones who were in the front before him, and the daunting came onto them that they may not see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم after this year, and they're trying to make what he's meaning by what he's saying. Then he tells them, أيها الناس, what month are we in? They all know it. The month of Hajj falls in the Hajj. But Al-Rawi says they remain silent. Sakatna. Until we thought. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remained silent for a little bit. As-Sahaba said, until we thought that he will name this month with a different name other than the one we know. And hadha from the adab of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum with Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani he told them, what month are we in? They didn't say anything. And then when he remained silent, they remained silent thinking he's going to name it a different name so they would not overstep the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and remain silent before him. And this is from them being in the hadra of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, as the hadith of Ahmad rahimahullah in the Musnad wal hadith Hassan, to say the least, that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke with the Sahaba, it was as if birds, ka'annama ala ru'usihim at-tayr, as if birds were standing on their heads. They said he remained silent until we thought he's going to name it with a different name. He said, aren't we in the Hijjah? قالوا نعم يا رسول الله. We are in the Hijjah. What city are we in? He asks them, صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, أي بلد هذا? Which city are we in? They know they are in Mecca. They walked to Mecca from Medina. A whole week, 10 days, they walked on foot. Lakin, just because they knew, they didn't feel that they should speak before someone who knows more. So they remained silent. Unlike us sometimes nowadays, we learn two words and we want to show that we know four. Can't hold. الحافظ العراقي رحمه الله says about someone, علمه أكبر من عقله. His knowledge is bigger than his mental capacity. He cannot hold it. I learn a couple of things, I have to go and flash my intellectual muscles on everybody else. Tell him, she, you don't know, but I do. الصحابة رضي الله عنهم knew that they were in Mecca. And he صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم asks them, which city are we in? They remain silent out of adab. They remain silent. Ibn Arabi, حتى سيدي أبو مدين, when he says, إن أقاموك أقم, إن أطعموك إن أجاعوك جوع, وإن أطعموك فكل, إن أقاموك أقم, أو إن محوك فزل, ولازم الصمت إلا إن سئلت فقل لا علم عندي وكن بالجهل مستترا. He says about the تربية, says if they establish you, you get established. If they remove you, if they erase you, you are erased. If they feed you, you eat. If they don't feed you, you're hungry. And if you're asked before them, say, لا علم عندي. I don't have any knowledge. وَكُنْ بِالْجَهْلِ مُسْتَتِرًا. And shield yourself with saying, I don't know. For how do you know and there's someone who knows before you? الْمَلَائِكَ عَلَيْهُمُ السَّلَامُ knew. Many things. Allah taught them many things. And they told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ. Allah reminded them, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا. سُبْحَانَكَ يَا اللَّهُ, we have no knowledge. إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا. Our knowledge is not, لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا, we have no ilm. Whatever we have ilm is what you taught us. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. والصحابة رضي الله عنهم are learning these أخلاق from the ملائكة as well. And these آداب, الآداب الملائكية. They said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم remained silent until he told them, aren't we في البلد الحرام? Aren't we in the sacred precinct? قالوا بلى يا رسول الله. نعم, we are. They said, we thought he's going to give it a different name. We remained silent. Then he told them, إن دماءكم وأموالكم وأعراضكم حرام عليكم. Your blood, your wealth, and your reputation, your dignity is as sacred to you as the sacredness or the sanctity of this month and this day and this land. ألا أخبركم, أو في لفظ البزار عن فضالة, وسأخبركم من المسلم. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells the sahaba what? Let me tell you who the Muslim is. Ya Rasulullah, you've been teaching us 22 years now about Islam, Iman, Ihsan. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us all in Hajjatul Wada', let me tell you who the Muslim is. Because you might have your own notions of who the Muslim is. Let me tell you, وَسَأُخْبِرُكُمْ, I will tell you who the Muslim is. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling the Sahaba and us, he's defining who the Muslim is. الْمُسْلِمُ مَنْ سَلِمَ النَّاسِ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ وَيَدِهِ. The Muslim is the one whom people are safe from the harms of his tongue and his hand. That's the Muslim according to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you don't make up your own, you don't conjure up your own definitions. وَسَأُخْبِرُكُمْ مَنِ الْمُسْلِمِ, I will tell you who the Muslim is. So you don't go and make up your own things. الْمُسْلِمْ مَنْ سَلِمَ النَّاسِ. الْمُسْلِمْ is the one whom people, all people, human beings are safe from the harms of his tongue and the harms of his hand. If people are not safe from the harms of your tongue and the harms of your hand, you're not a Muslim in the prophetic definition of what a Muslim is, in that complete sense. This is a final will, not just a prophetic sermon. وَسَأُخْبِرُكُمْ مَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Let me tell you who the mu'min is. So we don't separate theory from practice. We don't say Islam, we just testify and we utter the word and the practice is entirely severed from it. Who is the mu'min ya Rasulullah? Al-mu'minu man aminahu an-nas ala anfusihim wa amwalihim. Aw al-mu'minun fi lafz. And the mu'min is the one whom people are safe, or he can be trusted with people's reputation and property. Just because you're enabled to slander doesn't mean you should slander. Just because you may be able to indignify some doesn't mean you should. That's not who the mu'min is. Al-mu'min comes from aman, and aman means safety and trustworthiness. Al-mu'min is the one who's entrusted with the reputation and the property and the self of other people. That's who the mu'min is. وَسَأُخْبِرُكُمْ مَنِ الْمُهَاجِرِ I will tell you who the muhajir is. So you don't think hijra is simply migration only. المهاجر لسه الحديث في مسند البزار والحديث حسن to say the least رجال الحديث ثقات عن فضالة رضي الله عنه الأنصاري النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says المهاجر من هجر الذنوب والخطايا المهاجر is the one who migrates from his sins and evil doing if you want to be a مهاجر An immigrant or a migrant, like the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, who migrated from Mecca to Medina, you still can, according to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The true muhajir, the true migrant, is the one who migrates from the evil doing of himself or herself to do good. That migration is the hijrah. Wal mujahid, even the mujahid, yeah. والمجاهد and the one who does jihad من جاهد نفسه في سبيل مرضات الله is the one who struggles with himself to bring it to the obedience of Allah الحديث حسن to say the least this seems to be prophetic redefining of who the Muslim the mu'min the muhajir and the mujahid is. This seems to connect the practice with the theory. And this seems to also reduce this gap that some people may create because of their theory that la ilaha illallah is no longer good enough. And as it is sometimes today, Because to many today, unfortunately, La ilaha illallah is not good enough. What jama'ah do you belong to? And what party are you a member of? And what group do you participate with? And if you're not in my group or my party or my jama'ah, then your La ilaha illallah is not good enough. Therefore, you're not safe from the harms of my tongue and my hand. But that is exactly contrary to the very prophetic definition in the final will of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. For la ilaha illallah is good enough. This is to seize intellectual terrorism in the name of ijtihadi views and opinions. And it seizes and it chokes self-righteous superiority and exclusive privilege to what's right versus what's wrong, laying the frames of who the Muslim truly is, whom people, human beings, and nas, not just Muslims, all people are safe from the harms of his tongue and his hand. Then he tells him, أيها الناس, He comes now after this sallallahu alaihi wasallam to tell them the radical equity of people before Allah that all people are radically equal before Allah that there is no fadl of Arabi ala ajami and abyad and black over white or white over black or whatever except illa bittaqwa and he tells them also ya ayyuhan nas Allah ta'ala says obviously إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا We created you into males and females and made you into tribes and nations لِتَعَارَفُوا so that you can get to know each other the tribes and the nations get to know each other. Inna akramakum, the most honorable of you to Allah, atqakum, the one who is most pious, or the one who positively contribute best to self and others, that's the one who's most honorable to Allah. Not the one who claims, not the one who talks the talk, but the one who walks the walk. The one who contributes positively more to self and others as the one who's most honorable to Allah. Whether you are a male or a female or from a different tribe or nation, you're all equal before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For all of you are equally His creation. Your titles don't matter. That's dunya given titles. Your positions don't matter. That's dunya given positions. Your wealth doesn't matter because that's dunya earned or stolen wealth. What matters is your positive contribution to self and others. That's the meaning of taqwa. What have you done to improve self? What have you done to do to for good for others? Don't tell me what your title is and what you've been doing. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who knows the truth. You and your Lord. Don't ever let yourself fool you to think that the way that you look or the titles that you insert before, in the middle or after your name, or the kind of imama you have, or the kind of dress that you have, or the social community position that you put yourself in or assumed, or the kind of wealth or anything else that you have, makes you any different before Allah. You will go to Allah as naked as you came in. And all you can take is the only selfless good deeds that you earned. Any selfish deed will be left behind. You don't get to carry any deed. The only deed that will come with you is the deed that is selfless. Ala lillahi dinul khalis. Only. Last two, and our time is catching up. In 2 minutes, inshallah, I'll finish. Then he tells them to stand with the oppressed. And he talks to them about women's rights. استوصوا بالنساء خيرا. Women rights. That women, because as Allah said, يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم. We created you from males and females. We created you, made you XX and XY. So therefore, treat each other with dignity. Treat each other with respect. خيرا, with good. Al-Islam deenul khayr. It's a deen of good. And what you should treat each other with is good. لا تنابزوا بالألقاب. Don't call each other names. Don't think that what you know makes you better by itself. Amassing information never necessarily meant transformation. Iblis himself had lots of information, and lots of information of Iblis was accurate and authentic. But the information Iblis amassed did not necessarily mean transformation and realization. Don't be fooled by memorizing. Memorization does not make people of Allah. Internalization and transformation makes people of Allah good people. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns us from division. He tells the sahaba, hadith sahih, لا ترجعوا بعدي كفارا. وفي لفظ صحيح also, أو ضلالا. Don't turn after I leave. ضلال, deviants or كفار. يضرب بعضكم رقاب بعض. You kill each other and fight each other. Don't turn after me, deviants, killing each other and fighting each other and slandering each other and standing against each other. سباب المسلم فسوق. الحديث في صحيح مسلم. Slandering a Muslim is fisk. وقتاله كفر. And fighting him is كفر. He made you إخوان. He made you brothers in إيمان. This لا إله إلا الله is sacred. It's a sacred bond. It is worth more worth than earth and heavens. This is not something you take light. It has rights. Don't turn after me, deviants, fighting and killing each other. This is part of the wasiyya of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But with this part, it is the wasiyya that he left the final will not only for the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum ajma'een, who were present with him in Mecca, in Arafat that day. It is his final will and instruction for you and me all together that we uphold. It is the final will that we ought to live by. It is the final will of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell you that you will answer to him, because in one of the parts of the khutbah he says, wa ana faratukum ala al-hawd, and I will be waiting for you. I will depart, but I will be waiting for all of you at the basin. واللفظ, there's a riwayah, فلا تسودوا وجهي وإني مباهم بكم الأمم, and I want to showcase you to all the prophets and their nations. Do not put me to shame. That's what he says. فلا تسودوا وجهي صلى الله عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله. Do not put me to shame in front of the other nations and the other prophets. This Islam, my dear beloved, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left us is precious. It's not words that we just learn to regurgitate and speak. It's a state of consciousness, a state of the heart, and a state of the body, all three synchronized together. A walking person of Iman. It doesn't mean we won't slip. We will, we're weak. But it means when we slip, we never lose direction, because our direction is Muhammadun Rasulullah. I leave you with these thoughts. And the khutbah of Wada', like I said, is very long. It's actually long. I've gotten to, in the past 20 years, to assemble or collect out of the books of a hadith much more than what is available publicly. Authentic, some of them, most of them, Hassan, some of them, and bearable, weak, some of them. And inshallah, maybe some other time when we have more time, we'll expand on it, because what's available to most people out of the khutbah of Wada' is not really the full version entirely. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله والحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره, نستعين به جل وعلا, نستهديه ونستغفره, نعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا, من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له, إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى, وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم, وشر الأمور محدثاتها, وكل محدثة بدعة, وكل بدعة ضلالة. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده, ونصر عبده, وأعز جنده, وهزم الأحزاب وحده, لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده, أول بلا ابتداء دائم بلا انتهاء لا يفنى ولا يبيد ولا يكون إلا ما يريد لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام ولا يشبه الأنام حي لا يموت قيوم لا ينام سبحانه أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله أشهد أنك يا سيدي يا رسول الله جئت بالحق من الله مصدقا لما بين يديك أشهد أنك أديت الأمانة وبلغت الرسالة ونصحت الأمة وكشفت الغمة وعبدت الله ربك حتى أتاك اليقين صل اللهم عليه وعلى آله في كل آن وحين وارض اللهم عن أزواجه وذرياته وأصحابه وأحبابه والتابعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله أحثكم وإياها على طاعته أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته وأستفتح بالذي هو خير أما بعد يقول ربنا عز وجل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا وقال ربنا عز وجل من يطع الرسول فقد أطاع الله وقال ربنا عز وجل ما كان لمؤمن ولا مؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم وقال سيدنا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وذرياته وأزواجه وسلم المسلم من سلم الناس وفي لفظ مسلم من سلم المسلمون وفي لفظ النسائي من سلم الناس الناس أجمعون من سلم الناس من لسانه ويده وقال صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم كل المسلم على المسلم حرام كل المسلم على المسلم حرام دمه وماله وعرضه أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه يغفر لكم
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وأدم وأنم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وبارك وسلم وسلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل الصحابة أجمعين
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل وعلا نستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا عباد الله اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه راقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه تزودوا من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضاه اعلموا أنه لا يضر وينفع ويعطي ويمنع ويصل ويقطع ويخفض ويرفع إلا الله واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه قال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، أعلي يا مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيراً فوفقه إليه، من أراد بهم غير ذلك فاهده يا ربنا سواء السبيل، واكف عنا شرهم يا رب العالمين. آت أنفسنا تقواها، زكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اشف اللهم مرضانا، عافي مبتلانا، فك أسرانا، ارحم موتانا، اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا ولمن عن الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله. أقيم الصلاة.